sir.
Welcome everybody back to your coverage of the defense. Myself, Toby-Wan Kenobi, bringing you all your streams for this evening. Of course, it is from the Own3D TV sponsored tournament, The Defense, supported by Razer. And of course, shoutouts for you guys lovely here at joindata.com. And of course, you have multiple languages, German, French, English. The Russians are sick tonight because Fasuda has a cold. So big shout out to Fasuda if he is currently tuning in on his deathbed with his little sniffles and his tea and his honey and everything else you need when you generally have a cold. What we do need when we have a cold is a game, and that's what we're going to jump ourselves in. U-Boat versus Lowland Lions. We are jumping ourselves into Group B. That is right, Group B. So Lowland Lions currently are 1-2. They've only played 3 of their 5 matches. They will be playing out all of their matches tonight. Their last game will be against Natural 9, and that will finish off our entire competition. That's actually the last game next to Na'Vi and J4T. It's our last time slot. That'll be happening in about 3 hours' time from now, but we must get through this game to start with. Of course, where U-Boat currently sit in this competition, you wouldn't say it's a little bit better, in fact. They just played one extra game, and they are 2-2. So their last game now, if they win this, they go 3-2, which is the magical number to go through. 3-2 is what SK and Problem got through on. Well, it might be enough for U-Boat. It's a tough tournament, though, because J4T is also 2-1. Natural 9 is 2-1. So with, a loss from U-Boat, they could end up in, possibly 4th, 5th position, which will not get you through. You need to be part of the top 3 in order to advance in the defense competition. So, let's jump ourselves and have a look ourselves at the banning pool. And Anti-Mage is through again. It's the first thing I see. When I mention the 5 heroes you need to ban out at the start. Actually, sorry, not Anti-Mage. Oh, Anti-Mage is actually banned. What am I thinking? There's 5 heroes you need to ban at the start, and the first one was picked up straight away. So, Anti-Mage, Prophet, Nice Stalker, Broodmother. 4 standard bans. Lich jumps in and out of that as he will please. Here was the first pickup from the Dire. The Radiant side go up with Enigma as well as Windrunner. So Windrunner once again going to be seen inside this game. Really, I think she is the most played Dota 2 hero out of all the competitions. Somebody can try and find a stat for that, because I'm pretty sure she's going to be up there. If she's not banned, she is picked. It's just the way that Windrunner works. She fits into every single lineup. That Shackle is just so nuts. It is so nuts. You can disable 2 heroes at one time for maybe even a large extended amount of time during a team fight. There's no creep shackle to a tree. So many options for them. But we will be looking at Enigma as well as Windrunner. So they've got a good amount of push, good bit of jungle if they run it that way. We saw in our last game where Mouseports ran Enigma as the top lane solo, which does work as well. I think more than likely I'm going to be going back towards the lines of a jungle Enigma. And that's mainly because Lich is on the field. So they know they need to keep up with the amount of farm which they're going to lose in whatever lane Lich belongs in, and that is where they need to basically keep up to date with how much money you've actually got. Rasta was also the pickup from the Dire as their second one, so a little bit of pushing power, and also their solo mid, more than likely with Lich in it. I would say 99.9 recurring, of course, percentage chance that we will see the Shadow Shaman go for the solo mid role. To also explain too, Sexy Bamboo is in the roster again. That's because he's in a different group. So he's able to substitute himself in for Mouseports because they're in Group D. He's playing in Group B, that's fine for him to do so. That is within the rules of the competition. If you want to check out the rules, you can actually do so yourself. If you want to head over, it's on the Joindata website. The entire rule set is listed there. It's a proper written up rule set. There's a rule for absolutely everything that could possibly go wrong. And it goes a big thanks to Holy Master as well to make sure this competition runs smoothly. Absolutely smoothly. And looks like we're going to have Melonhead come in as our third pickup for the Dire. So a little bit more team fight potential when they have that Ravage and Lich ultimate go. And if they get the Shadow Shaman Wars in the middle of it, you're looking pretty hunky-dory. But you got the King of Team Fights as the first pick for Lowland Lions anyway. So the Enigma, such a great team fight hero. So we might have ourselves some action-packed kind of matches. And DK once again going to get into the pool. A lot of teams are really enjoying the Dragon Knight. He has kind of like found his way. He's found his way into this lovely, lovely world of Dota 2. Because DK kind of comes and goes in the world of Dota 1. Actually, that's a large period where he just went. No one even thought about him. But now he's being used as a big pusher through his Flame Breath. And a big tanker once he gets himself up, get a couple levels up and use that Poison Dragon. There's also a bit of a tip too. The Poison Dragon is actually the best one to hold on to until you hit level 16. Level up your stats if you need to. You want to level up your Dragon's Tail, your Blood, as well as your Flame Breath. Flame Breath first, as always. But mainly because you have the Poison. Really helps you bring down towers. Syndrome was explaining it the other day. You attack it once and you get 100 DPS over time on the towers. Same with like when you attack a hero. The same sort of thing actually happens. So it's a great way to bring down towers. And when you go into your flame form, then you get splash damage. But it's a splash damage, but it doesn't burn. There's no continuous damage going from it. That's why a lot of people prefer to keep that Poison Dragon up. And then when you get to your level 16, you have a Frost Blast. It's like having a Nova just fly out with every single bloody attack. It is just so powerful, the dragon. So keep a very, very close eye on that one. Also, by the way, for the guys who are PMing me on IRC, as well as a couple of guys in Skype, save your feedback for the lag issue until the very, very end of the match. I want to know then, not during the match. Just becomes a little bit more of a distraction if we try and do it during the match. All right, so let's have a look at our last set of bans. So Slaughter as well as Mirana being taken out from the Radiant side. And that's just because Slaughter, we were talking about it yesterday as well, just how well he works up against DK. You drop that armor off, and once that armor is gone, then DK really loses a lot of his power. So they're going to need a Medallion of Courage up on that Tidehunter as fast as he possibly can. Mirana's also been taken out too, just to remove out that side lane solo option. And they're going to go with a Nayx. You better going to run a Nayx. This, I'm interested to see where they run their lanes. I have a funny feeling we're going to see a solo Lich. Nayx going inside the jungle. And then Tide supporting on top, Shadow Shaman in the mid. And then our top lane solo. Maybe. It's kind of where I'd go with this, and it would work out pretty nicely because they kind of got to accept the fact they can't stop DK's farm. That's going to happen. But if you have Lich sacrificing one of every single creep wave and a small amount of harassment from range, they're looking pretty good. And Enigma, well, he's going to be ganking that bottom lane as it is. So that bottom lane is basically a wipe. They know that bottom lane is a wipe. So they have Nayx, they get him farmed up, they get Shadow Shaman up, and then they just push down the towers. Now force DK out from that bottom lane might be an option. But we'll see what the Dire want to do, just how far in they want to go for that, because it's a very, very risky option. Sometimes you can just wipe off a lane and go, yep, you know what, we're not going to win that. Let's win in other areas. We can't get the farm on the bottom. Let's pull it out of the jungle. And that's where Enigma can get that farm, or does he go towards the top lane? Is Windrunner going to solo that up? DK vs bottom, Enigma in jungle, Windrunner top, and then a solo mid. They can take anybody they wanted to right now. LLL have themselves a very, very nice lineup. And Weaver's going to be the pickup for the Dire. Radiant team pick. I'm actually even thinking right now that we could have a Lich and Tide on top, get them both up level 6, leave Weaver alone in the bottom, or put Weaver... Oh, how do they want to do this? Are they going to duel it? I still just have this image of Nayx in the jungle. He's going to level up faster if he's in lane, so more than likely, the way you'd normally say this is the way this should work, you would say, let's throw Nayx on the bottom lane with a Lich, we put Tide and Weaver on top, and Shadow Shaman in the mid. That would be the normal way of running this lineup. But I don't know. I'm just expecting something a little bit different from these guys. We'll check out the Radiant side, though. They have a very, very conventional lineup the way they're running. As I said, DK, solo bottom, possible solo mid, he'll be safe lane on bottom. We'll then have the Ventual Spirit roaming, possibly helping out the Enigma inside the jungle, but we'll be looking for those ganks in the bottom lane. So you got yourself a lot of stuns for that bottom lane. It'll be a triple stun when Enigma and VS come in with the Dragon Tail from DK, so it'll be guaranteed a kill. If they catch Weaver out with a single stun, if he is on that bottom lane, he is dead. It's the same with Nayx. You can't lifesteal if you can't attack. You do have that rage ability, and that could help him save himself from that bottom lane. So maybe that was what they're thinking too with that Nayx in the bottom, and then they might leave Weaver to be a little bit more safer up on the top lane. It's always a safe lane because the enemy has to go so far across the river. That's why the bottom lane is the safe lane for the Radiant side, and the top lane is the safe lane for the Dire side. You put your heroes you want as much farm as possible on those lanes, and Viper will be it. So there's their mid lane solo, so Sexy Bamboo will pick up that Viper. Well, if he's going to play the mid lane solo role, he should do. It's kind of his thing. And that way he can move around and go ganking a lot more. It's going to cause some issues for Nakes. He's going to want to get in close, but that skin's going to be a real pain in the ass for him. Not to mention if he's ever trying to run away from Viper, it's going to be very, very difficult to do. But that's what that rage is for. He's got to time that rage perfectly. It's like having a BKB at level 1 if you want to. All right, so now everyone will select their heroes. Remember too, I have been changing a lot of the settings up on the stream. You will need to hit that little refresh button. I'm not talking about Control F5. I'm talking about that refresh button, which is next to the play button on your own 3D TV player. That will let you reconnect to a new server because I jumped between like 8 different servers testing them out. So you'll need to hit that refresh button so it can rework what server you are going to connect to. So now we find out who has not picked up all their heroes and is U-Boat. Lowland Lions are ready to go, and Sexy Bamboo does have that Viper, so he'll be running for that solo mid. Deadman should be playing as our Dragon Knight. Evilist will be playing the raw support, Vengeful Spirit. FSM playing as Windrunner, which will be solo top, while Dutch Freak will go into inside the jungle. Well, Willie, did they have time to buy up any form of items? No, they did not. Over towards the Dire side, we have Dream Shock, because he played an amazing Enigma the other night. And not a Hax. Playing a Shadow Shaman, so he'll be running as our solo. And Smug. How the hell would you even say that name? Smugglig is the way it's actually, I see it written there. If we're going to use phonetically. If I call him Smuggling. Yeah, so he'll be playing as the Weaver. And just see what lanes they go to. That's why I want this pause to actually stop. So I can see what lanes they go. Damn it, guys! Get yourself back inside the game. It's Smalgalig. Smalgalig is okay. So Hjorn is letting me know it's called Smalgalig. All right, I'll try and remember that just for him, only for him, for Smalgalig. Smalgalig. That's going to be the worst thing to say during a team fight. I'm just saying. I'm going to call him Small. I'm going to call him Small. Small, okay. We're shortening his name to Small. It's like we shorten Kurokai to Kuro. That works for us. So he's now called Small. Yeah. So we just find out when these guys are going to get themselves back. U-Boat, funnily enough, is actually one. It's their captain who hasn't selected a hero. I don't know if they're just like, if he like finished his draft, said toilet. Could have been an option. Oh, Syndrome, what are you spamming me as well? That is like possibly the worst way to pronounce it, Syndrome. That is the worst way to pronounce it. Prepare for battle. All right, so now we're gonna see who else we got. So, Bonza. Oh, man. It's supposed to be Bonzai, I think. Yeah, Bonzai. His name is Bonzai, but he was on the end of it. Wall Eater will be eating, but not walls. He'll be eating life out of whatever he wants to take. And we do see the Quelling Blade Star Shield's Walls 1 Clarity, which leads me to believe he's going to go solo mid with the Lich. Yeah, he will be. And then DK is going to go the solo mid as well, so they put the two melees against each other. And Sexy Bamboo will take the safe lane on the bottom with Eventual Spirit support. Windrunner is going to be up on the top. And Enigma is just setting himself up so he can steal one of the creeps from the top lane just to help Windrunner out for the very, very start. So they're going to run the melee as well as Lich in middle lane for the Dire side. And at least Shadow Shaman to run what could be a solo top. Small will be playing as the Weaver on the bottom lane. And he'll be joined by Dreamshock, so we're going to see dual lanes in the middle and bottom for the Dire side for U-Boat, but not a Hax left by himself. He's got one level on Shackles as well. That is a rather unusual ability to skill up first. Most of the time you do look for the Aether Shock, that way you can harass and get those last hits in from range, but then even if you're going to go defensive, you go one level on the Hex. So I don't know if that was a bit of a misclick from not a Hax. I'm going to throw over to Syndrome, who is... I'm going to throw it to Syndrome, who might be able to help me out for that one. I know he's listening, even though he's supposed to be studying and working on his assignment. Damn you, Syndrome. Damn you. All right, so now Wall Leader. Dead Man's having a really hard time here in the middle lane. There's already one less creep. He has had one denied and can't get the denial himself because he's getting harassed by Lich. So this is not going to be his best lane ever. He has not had leveled up anything yet, so he's keeping his options open. And he's going to go the Dragon's Tail. What the crap? Okay, first blood. Well done. Why is Bamboo dead? Where is his support? Sexy Bamboo TP's back down again. But Weaver and Ty combine and get themselves a kill, and the first kill goes to Smull in the bottom lane. That's not where I was expecting that to come. Obviously, because I missed it. So if you are having a drinking game, welcome to it. Watching the mid setup now. Maybe this is just the guy I have to watch. He's looking for a kill. He's going to find Dutch Freak. And Freak's like, no. I have clarity going. I only just popped it. I need my mana. And Dreamshock's going to come back and hit him. So he's going to lose his mana. He already pops off his conversions, though. But Dreamshock wants to go. And because this now evils is near, and this is actually a nice play from Dutch Freak. He's trying to get his conversions to replicate out. So now he can initiate. So the first stun's going to come out from evil is near. And there it goes. Conversions have to get in range. But there's not enough mana for the Malphas. He's only 5 mana away. And that might have been enough to hold Dreamshock in place just long enough. Now Dead Mage is in trouble because they realize the support's gone from the middle lane. Dead Mage trying to retreat back. The open wind is not helping him out. And as well as the frost from Lich really causes Dead Mage a lot of trouble. That's why we see one level in Dragon Blood. I'm surprised that's not what he leveled up first. He went for the tail. But this lets him stay on the front lines and cop that harassment. Invis room for Lich, so it's more of a denial. Also interesting to see what Wally has got going on. Is that going to be a bottle for him? Open wounds again. Think they're waiting for Lich to come out for the frost. And yes, there goes the gush as well. Dead Mage, he's in trouble. Trying to get back to the tower. Evil is near, is trying to help out. And he can block Wall Leader in with his body right now. He tries to go through the trees, but Dreamshock is doing too much damage, forcing VS back past the tier 1 tower. And Lowland Lion's in a lot of trouble in the middle lane. They're losing their middle. They've lost their bottom from the first blood. And Weaver's off to a great start down there. And Nakes, not a hero you want to have any form of farm on, and the TP's coming in towards the middle lane. DK, I was waiting for that stun while Lifestealer was close in. But he has no real support to follow it up, and there's no like breathing of fire, there's no nothing, and there's that second level in Dragon's Blood. Just telling you right now, Dead Mage is not happy with this lane. Sexy Bamboo going one-on-one with a Weaver. And while Sexy Bamboo is so low level, it's level 2 on that poison. Shooky harassment. Because Weaver's got to be careful about this as well. Sexy Bamboo, he has himself Viper, so even if you do lose early on, if you get yourself a decent amount of farm up on you, all he needs right now is the ring from this shop. All he also needs is a bit of support from the side. VS and Enigma might do it, but once again, Dutch Freak does not have enough mana to land these stuns. And they need to land these stuns to try and stop Smile from farming on that bottom lane. Wall Leader's now having a great time in the mid. He's been left alone. Dead Mage is farming up the easy creep camp. Again, just showing you just how bad this is going. Gotta keep my Tide Cam on. He's already up on the top lane. He's only level 2 though. It's the downside for Tide Hunter. He's gonna fall himself behind on the levels. Would like to have a level 2 Gush or at least something else, and he's still gonna get towards that Ravage to have that Lich combo of Ravage and ulti, and then Weaver just killing everybody in the meantime. Could be the way to go. So that's what they're waiting for. The Shuki to go. They need the stun. Sentry gets dropped. Smuggling goes in, feeling pretty safe right now. So the first stun will hit. He's not in Shuki. He's currently locked in place. The Weaver wave will fly out. He Shuki's himself through because he can phase shift through everything. And there goes the Malphas stun. They lose the vision now, and also the Malphas on very, very low. In fact, the creep wave is blocked in Dutch as well as VS. They need to get rid of this, and Sexy Bamboo will get the kill on the Weaver. I don't know if they're actually blocked in there, or if they're just happy to fight from in the choke point. I think it was actually the latter. It looked like they were blocked. If only I could have my swing camera function, I could have found out. And now the tier 1 tower will take a lot of pressure from Dutch. Conversions will now disappear. And the TP support comes in, but they've already damaged down that tower to half. And the fortification goes as well, as Dutch creates another army of conversions. Doesn't want to lose these guys. Needs them to replicate out so they have a little bit more time for the siege creep to attack the tower. But Sexy is just like, you know what? I don't want any part of this. Let's get ourselves back. And the Converge's managed to... Well, I know, one gets killed off by a creep. And Smuggling will take off the second and now getting the third. He replicates out on the last hit of the attack. Dreamshock is now down the bottom line. They're looking for Bamboo. TPing. There is no sun. And they get enough damage. Only just. Where was his point of death? Oh, it was actually here. I was wondering if it was the Weaver. If like a German attack, like if there was a swarm, he didn't pop that off. But once again, Viper going down. He did buy up his boots, so he didn't really lose that much money, but it's giving more towards that Weaver, which is the more dangerous thing. Undead Mage is not really countering up this Lifesteal, who's almost about to pop level 6. Dragonstar will start off, but the tower's not hitting on top of War Leader. Now it will, but it's like a little bit too late. Two hits. Middle gank's coming in as well. Lich, Gush, Frost, and Dead. Open wounds meant there was nowhere for Dead Mage to go. And while there's no warning around here as well, they can't see that coming in. And Wally is going to run down here and pick up the regen rune. Whose ward is that? Is a Radiant Ward going to watch this? And Wally has got it. Regeneration. Getting everything going his way. Let's check out our CS scores for our top lane battle. Not a Hax, a 28 for 6. Not looking good. Windrunner's at... Well, actually, Windrunner's looking pretty nice at 32 for 12. But already forced back, and this is going to be a little bit of time for Not a Hax to catch up. In fact, advance. Just needs a couple more. And Windrunner is, technically, you can say, winning that top lane. The mid lane for War Leader at 42 for 18 with 3 kills on his belt as well. To the DK, he's got 2 deaths and 13 for nil. This is not working for the DK. And then down towards our bottom lane, where Sexy Bamboo is 1 for 2, 21 for 4. Going up against Weaver is 2 for 1 and 36 for 8. And everything is going the way of U-Boat, and you can see it right there on the goal graph too. 3k advantage, and we're only 7.5 minutes in. There needs to be more ganking coming out from Lowland Lions. They can't just sit back. But then again, Dead Mage needs levels as well. And they're giving up this middle lane freely again. So it's kind of like this trade-off. We thought they might give it up for DK. But U-Boat wanted to be aggressive. They wanted to win all these lanes, and they've done so. Every lane currently belongs to U-Boat. You can see it right now with Sexy Bamboo trying to fall back. Dutch is going to come in. There is no ward here. The time-lapse does go. But Lich is also here. He is just an inch off level 6 if this pops off during this fight. And it's going to be a very, very nasty surprise for Lowland Lions. You probably think, you know what, Lich, he's not level 6 just yet. Shadow Shaman gets a kill on Windrun, but we're going to stick here on the bottom lane. Lich is not level 6. He's sitting just on the edge. He could so use his ultimate right now. Now he's got it. Sexy Bamboo's got to be careful with DK. There it goes. Popping back to Bamboo. He pops his stick charge to try and live, but in comes Dreamshock, hurls off the Gush. Gets the kill on Viper. And Nima dies in the back end of play. And his Smuller is doing the job. The Sentry Ward is there so they can see him. DK trying to look for the stun, gets the stun, but Dreamshock looking for the Gush right now. He gets it on the Vengeful Spirit. It's the easier one for them to kill. Tries to throw out the stun. Dead Mage with a Flame Breath is almost enough. 5 HP on the Weaver, who runs off to the side. He's got no mana, he's got no life. I'm hearing a Shackle try and bring down Dreamshock. They can't catch up to him yet. 15 HP, that Tango is just letting him live, but now the Tango effect will wear off in a second. One last hit. He needs one more Windrunner. Is there a power shot? Yes, there is. There it goes. Meanwhile, back in the middle lane, Viper goes down. There is just no safe place for Sexy Bamboo. It kind of feels like the shoe is on the other foot compared to our last game. Just a reminder as well for those people who have been tuning in before but haven't changed their settings on their stream. You must hit your refresh button. Control F5 the page if you need to. But you'll need to refresh it after the server things I was doing beforehand. Guys in the IRC, please help out the guys who are also asking those questions. Top TP, Dead Mage is now up here. He's tried every single lane now. He wants not a Hax. He has those wards though. The Shackle's gonna land, but Dreamshock's coming in from the side. He is also level 6. Look for the Ravage. There goes the Ravage. The wards are dropped. Windrunner, you are Gonskis. Nice. Shadow Shaman gets the kill. And while those wards are there, Sexy Bamboo might TP in, but they cannot dive. Those wards control that top lane right now. Lich coming in towards the middle lane. It's to say hi to the Lifestealer, who's almost got his armlet up. The helm, and she's going to buy a magic wand instead. You both are always a big, big fan of these magic wands to magic sticks. Sexy Bamboo, open wounds, rage is up too. They can't stun him, but there is a lot of support from Lowland Lions. They need that rage to wear off, then Dush, there we go. There's the stun, poison as well. He needs to get out. Is there an ultimate? Yes, there is, but there is no creep for Wall Eater to jump into, and the black hole as well from Dutch. Hey, do not want this Lifestealer going. That cost a lot of ultimates. Lich is also here, sitting inside of Invis. If he gets a couple of lucky bounces, he can kill off Sexy Bamboo, but that's going to be a couple of massively lucky bounces. These conversions need to die before he can pop that. But also doesn't want to waste his own ultimate. Support's coming in. Invis is still there. Not a hack, doesn't have his ultimate up. But he does still have those stuns, and now Lich is going to go! Big hit! Sexy Bamboo was not ready for that. It was a combination of the first hit from the Lich ultimate and the Aether Shock from Not a Hack. I think Sexy Bamboo, yeah, he still has stick charges. He couldn't even pop off his wand. He did not have the time to even hit his hotkey. That's how fast that kill just happened. Blink of an eye kind of style. So great setup here from U-Boat. And U-Boat really want to take this game. They must win this game. If they don't win this game, they're out of the defense. And if Lowland Lions lose this game, well, you can basically say the same about them. This is an all or nothing game for them. They'd need some luck in their games for the other teams for them to get through to try and push it down to 2-3, 2-3, 2-3, which was the possibility that could have happened in Group D. But it's very, very contingent on the fact of winning some big, big games. Because Lowland Lions, they have themselves a couple more games coming up. We're going to watch our mid gank. That's coming up right now. The Gush is going. Weaver does get the kill on the Viper. There's the middle lane, which we'll watch as Lich gets that frost out. Evil is near. Is turned into a chicken right now and will go down. Not a hax with that double damage rune as well as the shock. Deals so much damage. And pops off the shock again. Gets all the farm on the conversions. Viper died right next to the tier 1 tower. It just shows you the confidence of that Weaver. Because he can have it as well. That's the power of time lapse. And now the tier 1 tower goes down in the mid. It's gone on the top because Lifestealer took that one against his armlet dumb. As well as treads and also with 1200 gold. He is only 700 or so away from completing up a Vanguard. And now they're going for a Windrunner. Windrunner's on the bottom lane and Smile's already just moving down looking to harass him. It's the tier 1 tower they want. Titus is Ravaged back up. Not a Hax is still 23 seconds away from having his ultimate, but they won't want to use this for the tier 1 tower. They want to use it for the tier 2. And the smoke is still up. Power shot will go, so they know Windrunner is there. But they need to push this creep wave up. Smoke is wearing off. I love how even Nakes is just farming up inside the Radiant Jungles, denying anything they can to Lowland Lions. Smoke will now wear off. Not a Hax takes care of the creep wave. And TP support is actually Windrunner's going out. Was not wanting to be part of that. Didn't actually get that latch to her. I thought that might have latched the Weaver wave. But this will be the death of the tier 1 tower. I love that he's dropped the mantle. What's flying in for him? Blink. 14 minute blink, arcanes and bottle. Not a Hax having a great time. Invis rune now on the top, so he'll blink up and grab that. And Weaver takes out the bottom tower. Almost with a Lincoln Sphere. It's going to make it next to impossible for Enigma to stun him, and VS wants to stun him or swap. The Dragon's Tail takes just one of these extra stuns out. Tidehunter has run into Sexy Bamboo right now. He doesn't want to have to pop off the Ravage. He's going to need to. He wants to live right now. He just tried to. Then he tried to a second time, getting shackled in. He can't pop the Ravage. He will die before he does so, but the Weaver Wave will come in, and this is not where they want to be with the Lich Ultimate bouncing between Bamboo. Bamboo lost so much life from that. Windrunner will go down. The Sentry Ward is there, so they can see him. Not a Hax comes in. There goes the shock, and it's also the combination of Wall Eater popping out of the chest of Not a Hax. A lot of burst damage around the area, and then he follows up with an open wounds. Titus a sacrifice, but they pick up Enigma, Windrunner, as well as Vengeful Spirit. DK is out, and Sexy Bamboo was lucky to live through that. But 4-18 now. And this is what I was meaning by they want to use these wards for the next tower. Putting him in front of the tower just to make sure the Lowland Lions doesn't get up on the high ground. If you put them back here, then sure, you'll be able to actually attack that tower a lot easier. But you put these wards in the front lines, you can take care of the creep wave, and you also hold your control on the high ground. And that's the more important thing from U-Boat right now. Looks like DK gets a little bit back, taking up the tier 1 tower in the mid. And then the very, very fast rotation. We just fly out there on the courier. So wards are back at the base. You've got phase boots up from Lich, so he can get in position to pop that ultimate. Or escape if he needs to. Lincoln Sphere is done on the Weaver. Not a Hax blinking himself away because he got that. Now has also brought up Drums of Endurance. That's sitting back in his stash. And then our last hero, War Leader. We've got a Mithril Hammer. Ogorax will follow shortly, and then the BKB recipe will be bought. Invis Rune from Dreamshock, giving them all the vision they need. And the Sentry Ward is dropped. Oh, they were not looking forward to that. And Dreamshock might even get out of this. He can pop his Ravage and live if he needs to. Viper gets one last slow. Support is coming in. He will turn around and pops a Ravage as well as Gush on Bamboo. It's almost a bait. War Leader will come in through the rear. Bamboo will die. This is a guaranteed thing. Or maybe not. The mech. No, it's still not enough. They try and turn around and fight. Windrunner gets out. Will he? Oh! Weaver gets it. Then Enigma to follow. But Windrunner went down, and now Ventral Spirit's also having a lot of issues. It was the Weaver wave, I'm pretty sure, that just caught the last hit then. The TP worked. The TP worked just then. But it was the Weaver wave, that the swarm, that did the job. Guys in the INC can help me out if I'm wrong. And now the tier 2 tower will go down as well.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Now the tier 2 tower is gone.
Radiant's middle tower.
And rotation out towards the top lane. Tier 1 tower is what they want. Shock will go and they will destroy off this creep wave nice and fast, which means the new creep wave can come in with a siege creep. It's a guaranteed tier 2 tower. Smiles is trying to get a range to that tower so he doesn't get damaged too much. Lich ultimate's up. Shadow Shaman's ultimate's up. Tide's the only one on cooldown for another minute. The Moland Lions can't know, even if that Tide ulti is on cooldown, they cannot fight this. There's just too much damage coming their way. Dead Mage in the meantime getting himself some form of farm on the bottom. I don't want to check this graph because I knew it was going to look like that. 14k. It's about to become a lot larger. Roshan's about to go down. It's a big shackle and they're using the Shadow Shaman Wars to bring him down. Gotta pop off all these spell shields off so they continue to drop down this armor. And there we go, the Gush, and that will be Roshan to Weaver.
Has fallen to the dice. Immortality.
Also, Nax picks up a Desolator. Having a lot of extra money, so Deso and Armlet. It's a lethal combination. So anybody who gets caught out by this is really going to suffer hard. And we're only 19 minutes in. He's got Armlet, Deso, Treads. I would like to see a little bit more life on him. He's only got 1,300. Complete up a Vanguard at least. But Weaver's also on his way to a Radiance. Lincoln's fear to start it, then he needs himself some damage. And then they can push. But Lich is also running down the middle lane. I don't know exactly what he's trying to achieve. Ward, okay. That'll be what he wants to achieve. Keep the vision inside the lane. Dire also have wards almost everywhere. Watching the Ancients, watching the transition down towards the bottom rune. Ward's in a little bit of a weirder place. In fact, both these wards are. To have this ward well, the sentry ward's fine. Jeremy would throw up on the high ground. It's just, and then this one down the side is like, what the hell? Good to see the guys are playing tic-tac-toe. But you better also want to finish this. Sentry ward's dropping again. I don't know who they're looking out for, if they're just looking... Oh, they can't be looking for anybody. No one's really got invis. There's no Mirana ultimate. There's no nothing like that. So just some... I don't know if he's just planting sentries for the sake of planting sentries. If he's feeling like there's a ward around this area trying to watch their movements, that could be the reason. If you're going to throw a ward at this point, you throw it up on this little peak. It's a great peak. Gives you so much vision. It's basically that area there, you'll see. But now the push will come on bottom. Everybody is ready. Every ulti is up from U-Boat. They will initiate and push now on the tier 3 tower. Wall leader is going to be the first one in. The wards will drop. And that tower is already down to half HP. And it's only been attacked for maybe 3-4 seconds. Shackle shot doesn't latch anybody. Wall leader is still tanking up this tower. New creep wave is going to come in. Fortification will buy them some time. But only a little bit. Now DK pops the ultimate. Sexy Bamboo is already down to half life. Smuggling wants to go through. Will he be able to get it? No, actually already. Yes, the black hole. There's not going to be enough. Lich's ultimate puts the stun in. And that cancels off the black hole. Evil is near, is getting shackled. And Weaver, while he is held in place, might think about time-lapsing this, but he won't. He'll save it for a rainy day. The Shackle Shot was able to hold Dreamshock as well as Lich together. The barracks is what they want. The blink comes back in again. Sexy Bamboo will go down. Maybe Shock, not there. Shackle shot once again, latching to the Titan. It's a good power shot. Shadow Shaman will actually die this if this stun lasts any longer, but he turns around and shocks. Can't pop the stick charges off just yet. They're still on cooldown. It's the only thing which will let him live through that. But the range barracks will go. The melee is gone. Lifesteal now with a triple kill. 27-5. The bottom is gone. The rotation's already happening from Not a Hax in towards the middle lane. Needs this creep wave to push down so they can push down the tier 3. But they also need all their ultimates back up again. Lich is on cooldown for a minute. Tyre's gone for a minute and a half. Shadow Shaman's gone for another 30 seconds and he also needs to heal. But the damage is already done in the bottom lane. U-Boat taking out the bottom barracks as well as a couple of kills. Forcing the Lowland Lions back inside their main base. Just to remind everybody too, this is not the last match for tonight. And I am getting a lot of complaints about the stream on this server, so we will probably jump ourselves to a different server for the next game. We'll go back to what we were using before. Seems to have less complaints, especially during the team fights. So obviously the team fights is the hardest time, Not a Hax with a BKB up to. 23 minutes, Blink Dagger BKB, drums, arcanes. Lich is walking around with a point booster. Wall Leader has him now, 3k gold. What does he even want to go right now? I wouldn't be surprised if he goes towards a rapier. He can even get Radiance if he wants to. 23 minutes in, you have that much money. Or actually, maybe even a... Oh, he wouldn't go Sanjay, Yasha. I'm going to watch this and see. Hello. Well, hang on, back in the middle lane. Should be watching this instead. Not a Hax. He is BKB, but he is swapped because that does go through BKB. Vengeful Spirit sacrificing his own life for the greater Bamboo. Windrunner trying to live through Lich as well as Tidehunter. It's a hard ask. Windrunner still on cooldown. Pops off the mech. Is currently slowed and will go down even though the Shackle did manage to latch Lich. Dreamshock finishes the job. And Bamboo forced to a rather unusual position. All the way up on the high ground. And the TP should go. Is he waiting for a hero or something? Nobody's there. They're all up in the top lane. Ganking Dutch Freak. It's an ethereal chicken. Now the Weaver Wave will fly in. Dutch is going to try and treat out, but there goes the Gusher with double negative armor and then the Anchor Smash to finish the job. Sexy Bamboo has TP back to base now. Now in towards that middle. He's gone Shadow Blade on the Lifestealer. So even more Invis, couple it with the Weaver. Smoke goes off from Sexy Bamboos, who he has, well, a little bit of extra movement speed, and that's basically it. Tower goes down, Power Shot goes through, it's a great Shackle Shot. Generally you do it the other way around, but in this case, it's just stopping Wall Leader from attacking on the creeps, attacking on the tower. Power Shot flies again, but that Lifesteal helped him so much. And there goes him in barracks. New boat. A surgical attack. Now they can go towards the top. The creep wave is already there. Swell's pushing through the bottom. Wally is looking for the killer and Windrunner. So the shackle shot unable to latch. Frost is the gush as well as Frost. Dead Mage with that BKB of his own. It's about to wear off, and the second it does, Wall Eater will turn around and attack Dutch Freak, trying to get himself a black hole, and he's going to get himself killed if he's not careful. Already gushed, now three heroes in, he does pop the black hole, but Wall Eater was sitting behind him when he did so, so was not affected by it. Back up towards the top lane. Dead Mage is doing what he can, but you got to say almost at this point it's a bit of a hopeless effort. Sexy Bamboo is once again on the run. He's going to pick himself up a regen room, but that's going to be it. He's already at full. And look how much damage that's doing. He did go rapier. Smile did end up buying the rapier. Four hits. There's all it took to kill off Viper.
Who's the number one now?
Windrun's looking for a little bit of a little bit of revenge. GG well played from Dead Mage. He's had enough. So is Streamshot's going to go in. He might even just pop his Ravage off considering he's so low. Doesn't want to come in range of that tower, but he's thinking about Evil is near, who has no mana whatsoever. Windrunner goes down. It's Weaver with the rapier. Evil is near is just running so damn fast, but Smuggling just needs one last right click. It's not going to get it, though. Eventual Spirit does the job. And not a Hax comes in to help out. So top barracks will go. LLL, there's been two guys who have disconnected. And let's make it three. The wards go down. The mid is being pushed. Sexy Bamboo fighting to the bitter end. But Small will come in. Weaver wave on him as well. Is there a Germinate? Yeah, there is. Four attacks. Doesn't matter if it's Germinate or not. It still does the job. And that is it. That is all she wrote. It is 36-5 is where we're going to end. Another one-sided game for this evening. Maybe we might have ourselves a little bit closer. Fnatic Man Psy versus Team Shakira. That is what's coming up next. Of course, that is Group C. It doesn't decide anything, but it's going to be a good, fun match. Two top teams. These guys know each other very, very well. It's a remake of the DreamHack semi-final where Fnatic MSI convincingly beat Team Shakira, but Team Shakira have been working very, very hard. They might be able to win it. Fnatic MSI are definitely the strong team at this point. But Team Shakira, they're playing in a lot of different competitions. Just getting themselves practice, working as a squad, knowing their opponents, scrimming against other people. Their biggest problem back at DreamHack was the fact they only played against Fnatic MSI. Well, not only, it was the majority, like 90% of their scrims were against Fnatic MSI. And that's, was a bit of a problem for them. There's your last stat screen. Do not go anywhere. We'll be back here in just a couple of moments with more defense action.